Thank you. drunk. It's distracting. I try and sing a song like that with a hair wrapped in wings. Does that ever happen to you guys? I'm thinking like, I gotta get this hair off. There's all these people standing out there. I'm trying to sing. That's good. That means I'm ready for the pros. Thank you.
top. Really smart.
Kansas City. Quasi. This is Bob D'Amico. Yeah! Jason Lowenstein. Lou Barla. That guy who played bass in Soul Asylum, Lou Barla! Sebadoh! Next song is called Skull. There is history in this place. There are dragons to be chased. Though I don't know who you are,
forgot to start the audio on the first one. Oh, man.
Okay. 1, 2. Jason's gonna sing a song. 1, 2.
I don't know if this thing's on. Maybe if it is, I'll come up a little bit, Bobby.
Thanks, man. I'm Thank you.
Sebadoh!
I feel as though I lack presence this evening. It's just feeling that way. I don't know if it's really going on. Alright. Here's another song. Ready?
Thank you. couldn't care. Cause all that matters is the way we choose to frame it.
First time anyone has ever requested that song. That's the second time anyone has ever requested that song. Ever. Thank you.
way too fast. Man, the song's only like a minute 40 seconds long and we managed to chop like 30 seconds off. Fuck. It's too fast. It's my fault too, I started it.
There's a bunch of words in there too.
That's a shitload of words, like I'm, my 44-year-old lungs are trying to wrap themselves around it. It's fucking pathetic. I really apologize for that. It's disgraceful.
forgotten about that song.
I'm not afraid to die.
So, we were meant to go on tour to support the reissue of our record Bake Sale. This came up like about a year ago, and I was in discussions with the record labels and whatnot. Sub Pop, that is, right? And we were finished with the record. We finally were finished with the package, and I communicated with Sub Pop Records, and I said, "Hey, the record's ready, ready to go. We're going out on tour. You know, it's all going to be there to support it." And they said, "Fuck you." So, we're on tour to support our new t-shirt. Yeah. And I did manage to guilt the record label into, I guess, theoretically releasing the Bake Sale reissue sometime in June, which is far after we will be done touring the United States. But that's okay. Anyway. That's the truth. That's the truth I should probably not bother to speak out loud. But that's the truth, in case you're wondering. Wondering why we have no records for sale. Wondering why we're making a big deal out of the Bake Sale and Armacy records. Thank you. So we do have a t-shirt for sale. $20. One-sided. Boom. And mostly we're on tour because we like to be on tour. Despite how unhappy I generally look or people think I am, I'm actually quite happy to be doing what I'm doing. So. Quite happy to be on tour with Bob and Jason and Quasi and the minivan and the t-shirt and everything else. And this song is called Beauty of the Ride. to doubt your boyfriend. Sebadoh. Rescuing wounded animals and returning them to their woodland homes. Sebadoh. Sebadoh. Sebo. Sebadoh. Those are names. When we were on tour, like early on, and we would go to cities, and we'd look at the weekly papers, you know, to the paper to see our ad, or even the ad for the clubs, our name was inevitably misspelled. Sometimes, one time it was S-E-B-O, Sebo. And it was Sebadoh. Sebadoh, which I like that one because it was sort of like as if we were a folk act in the tradition of John Denver. Sebadoh.
This next song is from a record called Bubble and Scream. It's a song that people generally don't request, so. But a song I like to play. Not that one. Not that one. See, you're requesting them. See, they're not the ones that I'm going to play. This is the song of a Bubble and Scrape that's generally not requested. No better than to jump up and down with this guitar. It's very fragile. All right. You ready, Jake?
I think so.
All right. Thank you.
song's called Give Up.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to end this set with some really old songs. These were on a cassette that I did back in 1986, I guess. So, anyway, we picked 30 songs to play. We were sort of coming down to like 28, 29, and asked Jason, what song should we play? And he said, well, to me, it wouldn't be a Sebadoh show without the song New Worship. So this is that song. That's what Jason said. So this is for Jason. This is our last song. This is our last song before our last songs. Just give us a second. We're really, we just can't really pull off this sort of encore thing. It's kind of embarrassing, honestly.
Nobody applauds when we leave.
That's true.
For most, it's weird coming back.
It's true, like for most of the shows, we would say, like, this is our last song, you know, like, and we would stop and people would just leave en masse. And we'd be like, come back! Wait a minute! Shit! Because the other thing is that after we're done playing, we're going to run to the t-shirt booth and hopefully sell you some t-shirts before you leave. So anyway, don't leave right away. Unless you really want to. We have, this is the last song, right? This is the climactic last song. The make-pretend last song. I'd like to mention that that Jason and Bob both live in Brooklyn. And I live in Silver Lake, so we're making a real connection here. We're making a real connection between America's
Army hats.
America's best neighborhoods. We're bringing it together.
Thank you.
Come on, that's fun.
We're a model of unity. I really should know that. I really thought I should mention that. And we're too old to be hipsters.
That's the other interesting thing.
Okay. Thank you. Don't leave. This is our last song.
Final.
This is the final song. This is my least favorite Sebadoh song. Not because it's a bad song. It's a pretty good song, really. I like it, you know, I mean, I wrote it. But it has all these awful associations with it. Because it was on the Harmacy record, and it was meant to be like the hit on the record, right? And we were on this record label, and they were pushing the shit out of this song, and they had people on the inside in Hollywood who were like, they were like making friends with people at Friends, the show, you know? And this song was meant to be like Ross and Rachel's breakup song. I'm like, man, I think we're almost there, man. This song, I'm like, oh, Jesus Christ. Like, I'm thinking myself, like, oh, no, it's not going to happen. So, no. But no, this is going to happen. It's going to be Ross and Rachel's breakup song. And we made this big fuck off Hollywood video for it. And we went out to the Eagle Rock, and there's a bowling alley out there, and we did this big video, and I wasn't living in LA at the time, this was years and years ago, and I walk into the video set, and I'm like, Jesus Christ, I mean, there's a fucking tray of bagels, and people running everywhere, and I'm like, what is this, how much does this cost, you know, and the guy, my friend, said, well, everything you see, if you see somebody, or you see a piece of lighting, or even the tray of bagels, it's $1,000. So just everything you see, just count it, $1,000. So the video cost about $120,000. And for that reason, we will never, ever see any record sale, any money from the sales of the Harmacy record. And yeah, I know, now we're asking, or trying to get it reissued. I mean, somehow already have like a big fucking, they have a truckload of the old records still sitting in their fucking warehouse. There's no reason for the record to be reissued. Logically, really. But, which, you know, the record industry like works against logic a lot, which I'm very appreciative of. And so anyway, that's right. It's willing to wait. I'm not going to get any further. Awful video, by the way. Terrible. Terrible, terrible video. It's the only video that we didn't actually sort of, you know, come up with the concept ourselves. And, you know, when you're reading treatments for videos, you might as well just fucking... If the LA skyline is in your video, it sucks. That's the thing. It sucks. And people still do that. You know, like Kings of Leon, you know, there's fucking... No, fuck, you're landing on the what is that bank? The Bank One building downtown? Oh, Jesus Christ. The crown of L.A. That building.
The Kings of who?
Kings of Leon. I like that band, actually. Mm. Guilty favorite of mine.
Sellouts!
Alright, so that's my big stupid-ass story about this stupid song.
That was way longer than just playing the song.
Way, way longer. Anyway, we're going to destroy the song right now. Ready? Actually, we're going to do a proper grunge rock version of it. So.
Cheers, everybody. Thank you very much.